a single weapon, more destructive power than the world has ever known. Awesome, undeniable, and frightening. To remember Nagasaki and Hiroshima is to remember this, that a single nuclear bomb can turn an entire city into radioactive waste. This is a fact. A fact that frightens the whole world. You who work with these nuclear weapons every day have often been told that the safety and safe handling of these special weapons are of primary importance. Safety standards are set and followed rigidly because there must never be any accidental detonation of this force. You know this. You've heard it all before. You see it, you read it over and over again. So many times that you may be inclined to take for granted the safety of the nuclear weapons with which you work. You've also seen safety films on every aspect of your job. And you may be inclined to take their message for granted too. But this film you are watching now is something special. Its message is one you'd better take to heart. The importance of nuclear safety is something you'd better fully understand. Because the safety and security of the free world are literally in your hands. It's up to you. Now, we may not like to admit it, but all of us live and work in a world full of risks we are willing to take. You can be killed just crossing the city street, and yet we cross. You can be killed just driving in your car to work, and yet we drive to work. You can be killed or injured just doing some routine job, and yet we go on doing our work from day to day. All of us live and work with these daily risks, and we live with their grim results, the annual cost in human misery. We pay for the little slips we are all inclined to make. Whether we like to admit it or not, these are the bitter results of human error or carelessness we are willing to accept. But in your job, in the business of working with nuclear weapons in any way, there isn't any acceptable accident rate. No risk the world is willing to take. No margin for error. The accident rate for handling nuclear weapons has to read zero straight across the board, day after day, month in and month out, and year after year. You can't slip anywhere because people everywhere are afraid of these weapons. They fear, and rightly so, their tremendous destructive force. They are afraid of the after effects, fallout, radioactive contamination. If we ever had a serious nuclear accident, the chances are that people would react. The chances are they would act even against their own best interest. Aroused by fear, public opinion here in the United States, and the pressure of opinion overseas, the pressure of our enemies, even the pressure of our friends would most certainly result in the grounding of nuclear weapons now carried in our aircraft. And let's not make any mistake. Unquestionably, our nuclear weapons, our ability to counter any hostile nuclear thrust, specifically our ability to deliver an immediate retaliatory nuclear attack, has kept peace in the world throughout the last 10 threatening years. But it has not been enough. And it will not be enough just to have these nuclear weapons in our inventory. We've got to be able to keep them in the air. And why? It's a question of time. You've all heard of time compression. You know how and why we've had to compress or cut down the time we used to have to launch our defensive counter thrust. The warning hours we used to have, even the warning minutes, have been reduced to seconds now. Now we don't have time to wait for the warning of an impending enemy attack before we begin the lengthy procedure of breaking out our weapons and loading them into our planes. Now we may not even have time to scramble already loaded aircraft and pilots alerted and standing by because, well, let's look at the map. Now you know how our forces are disposed around the world. You understand the political and economic significance of holding on to bases. Here in Europe, in the Middle East, in Southeast Asia, and in the Far East. You understand the absolute military necessity of having an immediate nuclear capability all along the rim of this free world we must defend. You know the importance of compressing time in our defense. Imagine then, what would happen if there were ever an accidental detonation of even the smallest nuclear weapon? It is extremely probable that, just for safety's sake, all our nuclear weapons would be grounded and unavailable when and where we might need them most. We would then be unable to provide airborne logistic support to nuclear forces based overseas. More important than that, the SAC concept of maintaining an around-the-clock, immediately available deterrent strike force armed with nuclear weapons, it would have to be scrapped. And even more important, SAC's airborne alert force would be disarmed. We would have no deterrent power with which to hold the Soviets in check and keep the peace. Nuclear warheads might be removed from operational weapons, thus disarming SAC's missile force. Thus, in face of an increasing Soviet missile threat, we would be forced to surrender the initiative to them. For by grounding our nuclear weapons, we would be throwing away the slight edge we now have, our ability to react quickly with little warning time. Without that quick reaction capability, our world, the world our nuclear weapons now defend, would shrink to nothing. Without that almost instantaneous reaction time our airborne and combat-ready nuclear weapons give us now, we'd have no time to bring our nuclear weapons from their storage tunnels. No time for safety checkouts. No time for loading special weapons on our grounded planes. No more safe margins for alerted airborne planes and men. Remember Pearl Harbor? It would be something like that, only worse. All over the United States, Hiroshima from coast to coast. Now, this is the price we'd have to pay for any carelessness or slip resulting in the accidental detonation of any nuclear weapon anywhere. That's the importance of nuclear safety, preventing this. That's why we say, it's up to you.